is so good. Greetings. What's up, YouTube? What's cool? What's groovy? What's happening? Hope everybody's having an amazing day. So today we're having another hashtag struggle food mukbang. Yay. So I got my pan, and this is like a spoon that has like two sides. So I've used this for something and I've used this for something. Hashtag minimalism. I don't actually have a lot of these. I have a few, but I've put them away and I'm just using one. I'm trying to see how I can live with just a few things. So I only own one pan, and that's this one, and I have this one, whatever you call it. So I warm my food up in a pan. Oh, now I know why the thing is looking funny, because I didn't put it down enough. Okay, now up it. Okay, I got my cucumbers. I'm loving cucumbers these days. It matches my water bottle. This is a new one. It kind of leaks, but you know, we'll just ignore that because I'm tired of sending things back to Amazon. So yeah, we've got here corned beef stew and rice. I warm everything up in this pan right here. And I kind of burnt the rice, so this is really a struggle. And yeah, the stew and the rice kind of mix. But it is so delicious. You caramelize the onions and then, yeah, you make the stew. It's really nice. I'll show you one time how to make it. But anyway, Lord, I have the Father, may you bless this food, may let it taste very good, may bless other people contribute to this food and other people that have made not as get sick of this food or anything at all in your mighty name. I pray with thanksgiving. Amen. So, I'm eating off of this childhood play right here. Because, why throw things away? I know it looks crazy, but it's delicious. And I have a lot of cutlery, and I still like using this. It's from Itsu, the place where you can buy sushi and stuff. Whoa. And it's delicious. Yo, you guys, this has never happened before, that I'm bringing the food to you piping hot. So these are some potatoes, and I basically seasoned them like I would a chicken. So it smells so delicious. I'm gonna have that as well. Not all of them, obviously, but a good amount. Basically, I think that's how vegans and vegetarians do their things. You know, you season it like chicken or like fish or whatever, and then it just tastes delicious. You know, when I was a kid, I used to hang out a lot with a cousin, and she would pray again whenever she got new food added to her plate. So you know, at like these African parties or weddings or whatever, they just keep bringing the food, bringing the food, bringing the food. This girl would pray time and time and time and time again. It was so funny, but it was good because you need to pray over all your food. So yeah, my setup is funny because it is really strange eating on a table that's higher than you, and you still can't even really see the food there, and then now you can't see me. That's very hard, you know. It don't work, y'all. I'll just show half of the food. Ooh, something like that. You notice how people that have lipstick on when they're eating, they eat very funny. They eat like this. Really hot, hot, hot. You know, some people do mukbangs and they don't even speak. That about to be me because I'm tired. Alright, anywho, y'all. I'm so tired because yesterday at work, I encountered a bully. A grown-ass bully. An adult bully. And I want to talk to you about grown-up bullies today. Because when we talk about bullies, we always think about like people that are trying to fit in, young folk, impressionable folk, but not fun. Anyways, y'all, I'm too tired to talk today. Like, I'm so tired. These people at work, they wore me out. I'm tired. I really am, you know. You know what I can never understand? Honestly, this food looks weird, and it's all like, the rice doesn't look soft, although it is. Trust and believe, it's so tasty.
Haters will say, hey, so is that the things that she's eating? It looks so disgusting. Anyway, she calls that one too food. Well, at least I ain't microwaving. I don't know what them waves be doing to my food and what it does to my insides once it gets there. I'm going back to the olden days. And so should you.
The saltiness of the corn beef and the sweetness of the caramelized onion. If you caramelize an onion really well, it's so sweet, almost like salty as well. It just naturally has so many flavors. I used to cook and then my flatmates would be all like, oh my gosh, what's smelling so nice? Onions, I've just started. Is it caramelizing or sauteing? Anywho, I know how to do the stuff, I just don't know all the terms. I don't quite know. But anywho, by the way, I had a potato in there that I put in on there when I was trying to see if it was done. So I took a tiny piece and I just chewed it and it wasn't all the way done. I was about to spit that thing out. Till I remembered, I used to have some friends in primary school that would just eat a potato raw. They would just eat a potato like that. They would skin it and just eat a potato raw, like an apple. Oh, and they wouldn't get sick. The stuff people do. How do you even come up with that? But I don't know if that's the same thing as like broccoli. Remember now, everybody's throwing raw broccoli in their salad. They're using it to dip, you know, things. Yes. And before I was like, broccoli needs to be cooked. Then it became broccoli can be grilled. Which, by the way, is amazing. One of my dear friends, she used to really not like broccoli. And then she started grilling it in the oven, just putting a little bit of olive oil and season the thing like you would a chicken. Just season it very well. Put it in the oven. Oh, it becomes cooked in the middle and super crunchy. You know the trees? The tree branches, the little thingies that the broccoli has. Yes, they become so crunchy, like kale, almost like kale. When you put it in the oven. And yeah, now she loves it. She just absolutely loves it. Everything you put in the oven is just... So yeah, I sometimes do that. I put everything in the oven. Even food like this, I could heat up in the oven. And then from there, they went to frying broccoli, I'm sure. Because they even fry milk now. Milk, adult bullies. I don't get them. At this age, what are you trying to gain? Popularity, more friends, or do you just still get a kick out of bringing other people down? Like, what is it? I really don't get it. And this might have to be a separate video, but I especially don't like it. People that are in power position, or people that have, that are like in charge, or just people that know more in general. I have to teach people that are new or do not know a lot how to work things, how things go and stuff like that. And then they do it, but not with zeal, not with love. No, they didn't know those things. I don't even like you ask for a question. It's like, number one, how do you not know this already? I don't know how, but if everybody greeted me with the attitude that you're coming at me at, that you're using to come at me, then it's not too surprising that I don't already know this thing. People are genuinely scared. What was I even talking about? Okay. So like, some people, it's really hard to ask them questions like, how do I do this? Where can I find this? And stuff like that, because they always greet you with an attitude. So then people go around for years and years not knowing how to do stuff. Not ask. I don't give a hoot. I'm like, you might think this is a stupid question today, and I might look like a silly person in your eyes today. But tomorrow, when I go somewhere else, they're gonna be like, wow, you know a lot of stuff, dude. There's no point wandering this earth and not learning everything. And learning from people is one of the sweetest things. Like, it's really nice. What I also don't get is that a lot of people don't have that mentoring spirit. And you know, I want to teach this person something because I want to mentor them and I want them to be better. Heck, even if it's for selfish gain, I want the person to say, I got that from, I learned that from. People don't even think about that. Even the most narcissistic people are so narcissistic that they don't even want that credit. That they're so self-centered that they're like, I don't got the time to be dealing with you. I need to do me. However you're gonna survive, that's not my problem. That's none of my beeswax. I don't care. All I say is, at work, especially at work, don't be dismayed and ask your questions. I have so much I want to say and I feel like I've already said it, but I probably just said it in my head. That is how tired I am. Tastes so good. What was I saying? See, this is how you do portion control. You only eat what you know you can eat and what you're gonna eat. None of this is nonsensical mukbang. I can't breathe things. Every single day I can't breathe because of food. Ah, like my mom would say, eh? And then if somebody say fire, and you now need to run, now you cannot even run. That's why those people that are lean, they're all like the Bold and the Beautiful diet. You know when I used to watch the Bold and the Beautiful? Are they still going? I know the place rich. Oh, that's really sad. But anyway, they would just be eating a food that is like a cucumber with some rice heaped on it, with a squirt of mayonnaise on the top. Now, with this thing, that green thing that is thin, I think it might be lemongrass. You put it like an asterisk on top of the whole shebang. That's their food, though. These people stay skinny. The woman who plays broke in an interview once said that she drank like 3 liters a day. Up to 3 liters a day. This, my friends, is 2.2 liters. But To be honest, I've drank 2.8 liters before. Because I take this to work, and then I have my thermos, which is 600. And it's 2.2 plus 600 milliliters. So, don't know about ounces, y'all. I don't know them things there. But anywho, I'm going to write some stuff down, then I'm going to come back.
Yeah, no, it was becoming a bit wild. I was too tired. I had to take a nap. So part two is coming where I actually break down the 10 antics of these workplace bullies. And you're probably going to recognize a lot of them, if not all of them. And how to overcome these workplace bullies. It's a very interesting video, which I will drop this week. So keep an eye out. Make sure you hit bump stomp as well as the subscribe button. And hit the notification bell whilst you're at it. Join the crew. We do everything up in this piece. It's a lifestyle channel. Tap the like button too if you like this video and found it informative. Many more to come, and I'm posting every single day. I'll see you tomorrow. God bless. Mm-hmm.